Hey guys, this is Clinton Jeff, and today we're talking about the Adidas Yeezy Boost 350 V2 in the Zebra colorway. First things first, I hope all of you all are staying safe. We're actually in week 5 of the lockdown here in Malaysia, and things are finally starting to get a little bit better here. But that being said, it's 5 weeks of me at home and I'm starting to go a little insane. Speaking of insane, Adidas is doing yet another restock of these shoes. So I figured, you know, why not make a video about them? At one point, the Zebra colorway of the Yeezy Boost 350 V2 used to be one of the most limited V2s around. But there's been so many restocks of these, I think the one coming up is the 4th or the 5th, making this now one of the most common V2 colorways around. As an early owner of this colorway, admittedly, it doesn't feel too great because these don't feel as special anymore. But hey, that's just how it is. The restocks are all exactly the same shoe except for a change in the production date. So resale on these is definitely going to drop quite a bit since there's going to be so much more on the market. All right, let's talk about this shoe. Starting with the upper, you have the same thicker Primeknit that you find on most of the earlier 350 V2s. If you never tried on a pair of Yeezys before, these are pretty similar to the Primeknit you'd find on the earlier Ultra Boost, but much thicker. It's slightly less stretchy, but still very comfortable, and the thicker Primeknit actually allows the shoe to have more structure while still remaining breathable. The Primeknit pattern here is in this white and black color scheme, hence the zebra name for this colorway. Those zebra stripes are especially obvious when you look at the medial side of the shoe. Most of the earlier 350 V2s had a similar pattern but in other colorways, and this was eventually dropped for the newer solid color pattern that they have now. Apart from that, you have that signature Yeezy exposed stitching going from the toe box area to the top of the tongue, and then from the top of the heel down to the midsole. This is one small detail that I actually really liked about the earlier 350 V2s, and unfortunately this has changed with the newer colorways. And then apart from that, you have those signature Yeezy rope laces that weave through the upper. These laces are just regular all white and aren't 3M reflective like some of the newer Yeezys. Coming down to the lateral side of the shoe, you have that usual stripe that you see on most 350 V2s, but this time in all white. This stripe is opaque and not translucent like some of the newer V2s, and has this hit of color with the bright red SPLY 350 written on top. I actually really like how that bright red kind of steals your attention away from the zebra stripes. Of course, no one except Kanye seems to know what the SPLY stands for. Some people say it stands for supply, some people say it stands for Saint Pablo loves you, which is weird, so hopefully not that. Either way, it doesn't matter because of course this design was also dropped for the newer V2s. Coming to the back of the shoe, you have the heel tab, which has now been missing from some of the newer V2s, but it also wasn't present on a couple of the earlier V2s either. I'm one of those few people that actually like the heel tab on the back, so I'm happy to see whenever they pop up on the newer colorways. I feel like the V2s without a heel tab just look kind of incomplete, but that's just me. And then coming to the inside of the shoe, you have this really great padding towards the heel with the Adidas 3 stripes here. And your feet go up right against that raw Primeknit on the inside of the shoe. There's also these patches of suede inside to reinforce the lacing system, which definitely helps with comfort. Apart from that, there's the usual Yeezy insole with the Adidas Originals logo and Yeezy written in black. And then moving down to the midsole, you have a signature Yeezy midsole with ribbing that everyone has seen for a while now. The midsole here is a semi-translucent white, but on my shoes, you can see that the rubber does tend to oxidize quite a bit and turn more and more yellowish brown as the years go by. You can also kind of see the Boost midsole within and where the midsole connects with the upper because of the translucent midsole, which is definitely kind of cool. But that being said, one thing that has really bugged me about this pair is this area here where the outsole connects over the midsole. I think a lot of other shoe tubers have also been annoyed with this, but I just hate that they're both two different colors. The outsole is this creamy yellow color, so next to that milky white of the midsole, it just kind of looks like one part of the shoe is yellowing faster than the other parts. It's just a really weird design detail that has always really bugged me on all V2s, but it doesn't look too bad on colorways that have a darker midsole unit. And then lastly, the bottom of the shoe is your usual 350 V2 outsole with these little cutouts for the Boost. For any of you all that have tried out a pair of Yeezys before, or any Ultra Boost for that matter, you probably already know how comfortable Boost is, and that is the primary reason why the 350 V2s are such a comfortable pair of sneakers to wear. Coming to fit and sizing, if you have narrow feet, you can go true to size here, but I have really wide feet, so I try to go up half a size or up even a full size if I can. It is a bit of a snug fit though, so even if you have narrow feet and you want a more relaxed fit, you could still go up half a size. They fit like any other 350 V2, so that hasn't changed. I know it's really hard to try out these shoes first because it's not like you can walk into a store and find them, but if you've never tried on a pair of 350 V2s before, I would definitely advise doing a bit of research on sizing. Alright, with all of that out of the way, let's take a look at the Adidas Yeezy Boost 350 V2 in the zebra colorway on feet. Thank you. all, the Adidas Yeezy Boost 350 V2 in the Zebra colorway is my favorite silhouette so far from the line. I just think this is a really clean looking sneaker that you can pretty much wear with anything, mostly because no matter what you wear, the shoes will still always pop. If you haven't been able to cop a pair of these so far, the restock is supposed to happen on June 27th and seems to be limited to just here in Asia though. Of course, because of the current pandemic situation, there might be a change in dates, but hopefully it'll drop everywhere on time. Otherwise, reseller prices have also been dropping, so if you're lucky enough, you might even find a pair close to the retail price. Alright guys, so that was a quick look at the Zebra colorway of the Adidas Yeezy Boost 350 V2. Please remember to leave a comment below letting me know what you think about the colorway, and is Adidas and Kanye doing the right thing by having so many restocks of the shoe, or should they have maybe kept this more exclusive? As always, if you have any questions about the shoe, you can let me know right in the comment section below, or you can ask me right over on Instagram or Twitter at ClintonJeff. And hey, if this video was helpful, don't forget to hit the like button right below, or maybe subscribe because that would be appreciated. And yeah, that's about it. Thanks for watching guys, and I'll catch you in the next one. Thank you.